Laboratories in the public sector have lagged behind in performance, especially quality performance. There's been a lack of knowledge on the benefits of giving out quality public service.
The other challenges are the delay of supplies, because when you order your supplies, they take some time before you get them. And so at times, there are some tests you are not able to carry as expected. The turnaround time is affected because of the delay.
Initially, there was no standardization. The way I would do, let's say, a test is not the same way my colleague could do the same test, because everybody had their own way of doing things.
The laboratory subsector is one sector that was over the years neglected. We invested more in clinical management than the, you know, result-based, evidence-based patient management. Our thinking is now to reverse the same practice and invest in the system. Laboratory happened to be one great system, a backbone of healthcare delivery. Therefore, we plan to initiate more investment based on the laboratory performance itself.
Laboratory accreditation is a way of gauging a laboratory in terms of standards. They're graded according to ISO 15189 to see whether they keep quality records, they do performance of quality assurance, and they give timely results.
The stepwise laboratory improvement process towards accreditation is a framework that was developed by the World Health Organization to help laboratories in developing countries to achieve accreditation. Achieving accreditation for developing countries may be a challenge because of issues of financing, issues of maybe staffing. It's a friendly process through which these developing laboratories can achieve accreditation. It is a document or a checklist that was developed by the World Health Organization. It has around 12 quality system essentials.
Before it came, I can see where we were. We were not documenting anything. We were not doing the IQCs, that is internal quality checks. It's like we were just working, but we did not have anything to look back and see what we've done.
It requires that staff be trained, staff understand the process, staff develop teamwork, staff own up the process before now it can take off. So by doing it in a stepwise manner, it creates that issue of ownership, it creates an issue of teamwork.
We didn't have them picking up so much so fast as we expected, so it took more than 3 years. So we decided, okay, let's have a way of motivating the laboratories to give good performance. So we've tried to now to enlist the laboratories under the project into the BBF scheme. Most of the labs now in Kenya, they're above 2-star. I think if we introduce BBF, we'll have them getting full accreditation.
Performance-based financing is a strategy based on desired results. We agreed on some results, you give me that result, and then I incentivize you based on that. So no results, no incentive. Where performance-based financing has been introduced, it has ended up in improving staff motivation and improving even the outcomes. In Rwanda, performance-based financing is actually part of the national policy. Immediately they brought in performance-based financing, they started improving faster. So it goes to tell us that performance-based financing really works.
Most of them are now in 4th or 5th and are ready for accreditation. So we saw performance really, based financing has really helped the process of accreditation in Rwanda.
If we have performance-based financing, I hope we'll take a shorter time to achieve accreditation. That's our main goal and objective.
Performance-based financing as it is structured, we expect that we'll be given money according to the way we are performing. So that in itself is a motivation factor. The better you perform, the more financing you are given. So that is going to spur staff and everybody to work towards accreditation. Also, we are going to be given financing to do the things that we could not do because we were financially challenged. Things like calibration of equipment, putting our equipment on service, maintenance schedules, and many other issues that required financing that we could not do before the previous assessment.
When performance-based financing will be introduced, I hope staff will be motivated. They are going to work as a team, and at the end of the day, we are going to achieve 5-star status. Currently, we are doing at 3-star.
I think for a case in BBF in the lab, for the project, I think the challenge would be we introducing performance-based financing in the laboratory, and yet the other people who are contributing to the services, including the clinical areas and the nursing areas, they'll not be participating in the performance-based financing. So probably they will face a lot of challenges from the other division within the hospital fraternity.
The challenge we envisage is issues of sustainability of the performance-based financing. We have rolled out performance-based financing. The project, EPHN project, is time-bound. So after the project exits, you know, what happens? How are we going to sustain this? And these are discussions we need to start having as we progress with performance-based financing.
The Kenya government health delivery system is devolved. So the health system is at the county level, and the project works within the county government. The county government is eager to, you know, take over the leadership of the project. And within that, we plan to institutionalize the program and budget for it. And therefore, we think that that will sustain the project over the years.
I think the ideal resource that we desire to see more test menus being introduced, the number of tests being done should rise immediately after that, and they'll be able to be comparable to other laboratories in the world.
I expect staff now to be more motivated. I expect there to be better efficiency. I expect the project results framework and deliverables to move a bit faster. And actually from the literal engagement we have had with the participating laboratories, they're really looking forward. And everyone thinks this is a good way of motivating people and making sure that we're able to get better results faster.